Hello, in this section we'll talk about formulas, functions and cell references. So formulas and functions in Excel are used to make some calculations and they both start with an equal sign. So in order to make Excel know that we are entering a formula or a function inside the cell, we should always start our input with an equal sign. So in this way, Excel will know that we are not entering just a random text and we are entering a formula or a function. And formulas are used to do some basic arithmetic, for example, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and exponents. And exponents mean that we are raising a number, for example, to the power of 2, to the power of 3, to the power of 4, etc. In this workbook, I will show you the right way and the wrong way to add two numbers together. So let's say we've input in cell B4 the number 2 and in cell B5 the number 4, and we want to add these two together. So the first method is to simply write equal. So remember, we should always start with an equal sign when writing a formula. So we write equal 2 plus 4, and this will produce the answer 6. The second method is to start with an equal sign. However, now we write the name of the cells. That means B4, the content of cell B4, plus B5, the content of cell B5. This will also produce the number 6. Although the two methods will give the same right answer, however, the second method is the right way to do this calculation, since it uses cell references. So in order to show you what I mean, let's say for example we change this number 2 in cell B4 to 3. So you can see the first method will always give what 2 plus 4 is, which is always equal to 6. However, the second method, which use cell references, will give the content of cell B4 plus the content of cell B5, which in this case equal to 7. So using cell references is the right way to do the calculations instead of the hard-coded method. Now let's talk a little bit about functions. So functions are some pre-made or built-in formulas that are already present in Excel, and each one of these can do a specific task. So there are several functions in Excel, and there are functions for statistics, for mathematics, engineering, finance, and etc. Mainly the general syntax of a function, of course we always start with an equal sign, then the name of the function. Then between two parentheses, we should write some input arguments required for this function. So some functions have no input arguments, others can have one input argument, and others can have multiple input arguments. Examples of functions, the sum function, which give us the summation of some numbers, the average function, which give us the average of some numbers, and the square root function, which return the square root of a given number. Now let me show you an example of using a function. In this workbook, let's click down the function sheet here, and let's say we want to take the average of these numbers. So the first method is to manually add these numbers together and divide by their count. So first, we need to figure out how many numbers we have. So here in cell B2 we have row number 2, and in cell B14 we have row number 14. So in total we have 13 numbers. Another way to know the count, we can select all these cells together and we can look at the status bar here and read count equal to 13. So the first formula is adding all the content of these cells and dividing by the count, which is 13. And this will produce an average equal to 12.62. Another way to know the average is simply to use the average function, and will also produce 12.62. Now let's see what happens if we change some numbers here. So both formulas will give us the same correct answer. Now what is the problem? The problem if we delete some numbers. So let's say we delete two numbers. Now instead of having 13 numbers, now we have 11 numbers. And in this formula, we are still dividing by 13, which will give us a wrong answer. However, the average function will always give us the right answer, since it is taking the average of the cells of only the cells that contain numbers inside of them, and it is disregarding these two empty cells. So that's why the average function is giving us the right answer. Now you know about formulas and functions, let's explore other ways to use them in later videos.